Hello viewers, okay, in front of you we are discussed one new condition, that is the wasp and bee stings. Okay, it is a one type of disease condition, that is the wasp and bee stings. Okay, let us discuss this condition in detail. What is mean by wasp, what is mean by bee? Okay, we are identified especially in this honey. Okay, in that honey, these type of animals or this type of bee and wasp we are identified. Okay, in this bee and wasp, what is the problem means, once they are give some stings, okay, stings of the human body, once they are give some stings to the human body, means the human body will get some type of poisons and the body will produce some type of reactions. Okay, in this once the child undergone this type of wasp and bee stings, the child may have the local pain, means which part on the face or eyes or cheeks or upper extremities or lower extremities or all over the body, okay, which part will be affected by the bee or wasp stings, that particular part may be having severe pain. Okay, particular part having the pain and sometimes itching. Okay, the child may be shows some symptoms like itching. Okay, another symptom like stinging sensation. Okay, they are having the one sensation, that is the stinging sensation, and which part is affected, for example finger or cheek or eyes or face, okay, which part is affected by this bee stings or the wasp stings, that particular part will be swelling. Okay, complete fluid should be accumulated in that particular part. Sometimes in this condition also the child having the difficulty in breathing. Okay, in the normal individual, what is that protecting body means, breathing will be normal, circulation will be normal, temperature will be normal, means there is no problem to the body. Once the body will get or once the body will changes in the breathing, circulation, temperature, means the child may have the some complications. Once we are protecting these problems, means the child will be healthy, normal. Okay, in this condition also the child having the difficulty in breathing. Okay, these are the symptoms we are identified whose child undergone the bee stings or wasp stings. Okay, in this we are going to discuss about management for the bee stings or wasp stings. Okay, in this management especially we have to administer one procedure, that is the bicarbonate soda, means simply in home baking soda is there, no, for preparation of food we have to use baking soda. Okay, we have to take baking soda or bicarbonate soda, it will be dissolved in a few drops with the water. Okay, we have to take some quantity of water. In that water we have to use some baking soda, add it and it will be dissolve it. After that we have to add a drop of vinegar or clarified butter. Okay, which is available, vinegar is available, means we have to add vinegar, or the ghee butter will be available, means that butter should be added with the baking soda. Okay, these or sometimes vinegar is not available or butter is not available, means we go for the onion juice. Okay, onions is there, no, that will be cut it small pieces and that will be used in the mixer jar as we have to prepare onion juice. Okay, the onion juice and baking soda, these two will be mixed in the water. Okay, this will be give over the stings, means which part is affected by the bee stings or the wasp stings, that particular part will be applied by this type of lotion or the homemade remedy. Okay, after that the problem is not cured, immediately we are administered some anesthetic lotion or the cream. Okay, this anesthetic lotion or cream or calamine cream we have to apply on the topical application. Okay, which part is swelling or which part is having the edema formation? Okay, that part should be applied anti or anesthetic lotion. Okay, next one is the we have to apply the ice pack on the particular part for reducing the pain. Why? Because once the child will be affected by this bee stings or the wasp stings, those are having the pain. Okay, for relieving pain, we have to apply ice pack on the particular affected part. Okay, next another one is if bee stings will be visible, sometimes that particular affected part having the bee stings will be there, means that will be removed with the help of scissors or the tweezer or fork. Okay, which is the blunt item will be there, with the help of blunt instrument we have to remove that stings. Okay, next another one is the we have to administer the one drug or one medication, that is the paracetamol drug, for reducing or for maintenance of normal body temperature. Okay, whose body will be improved body temperature or the altered body temperature, for maintenance of normal body temperature we have to administer the paracetamol drug. Okay, another one is the phenargon. Okay, another drug we have to administer for relieving the pain. Sometimes the child will be showing some itching on the particular part. Okay, for control of itching, for reducing that particular itching, we have to administer the phenargon drug. Okay, by doing these activity the child not getting relief, means we have to administer the admitted in the hospital. Okay, by administration of this topical ointment or some drugs, there is no proper result, there is no proper curation of the child, means we go for the hospital. Okay, for better treatment, for improving the child health, for prevention of this complication, for reducing these symptoms. Okay, another one is the anaphylaxis treatment. Sometimes the child will be having the wasp stings or bee stings, they are having one symptom like anaphylaxis reaction, means due to the anaphylaxis reactions, small tumor formation or the small rashes. Okay, sometimes the skin will be changed. Okay, these anaphylaxis reactions will be controlled or reduced by administration of epinephrine drug. Okay, in the presence of epinephrine drug we have to reduce this type of anaphylaxis reactions in the children. Okay, this is regarding wasp sting or the bee stings. Okay, finally one conclusion is there. In this we are not allowed the children's alone. Okay, in the which is the unsafe area or sometimes the trees. Okay, in the big trees there is one type of bee stings or the wasp stings. Okay, why? Because they are living in the trees. Okay, they are having a one home-like nature. Okay, they are fulfilling their basic needs in that particular tree. Okay, once the child doing some activity, means small stone take and they are give some they are applying pressure on the that particular wasp or the bee. Okay, immediately they are giving some stings on the children's health. Okay, when the child getting this type of bee stings or wasp stings, there is some abnormality in the children's body. Okay, for preventing these complications, for improving their health, we have to give some health education to the children. Don't go nearby wasp or the bees. Okay, once you are going, means you are doing some negative activity in front of this type of wasp or the bee. Okay, they are giving some side effects or some harmness to your body. Okay, like that we have to give some differentiation, some positive points or preventive measures to the children. Okay, the child will getting idea regarding okay this bees and wasp will be very dangerous to the human body. Okay, we are not disturbing to the wasp and bee. Okay, like that the child will have some idea in their mind. The child improves their health. Okay, regarding this, this is the conclusion regarding bee stings and wasp stings. Okay.